switching the page a bit, there have been a few personnel changes to take place in the city of Jackson in the last week plus, I guess. We've already talked about the interim or the public works department. Just of note, as we recognize the departure of Mr. Woods, that Robert Lee is in the interim position. We do have a few more candidates that have been presented to us. And so we will take our time going through that. And as always, we thank Mr. Lee for his willingness to stand in, keep the department together, his knowledge, his institutional knowledge of the department. And so I thank him for his hard work. And so we'll continue to look forward to how we increase the bench of our Public Works Department. We know that they have a significant task ahead of them, that there are a number of things that are public facing that our Public Works Department accomplishes on a day-to-day basis. And so I thank him, and I thank the men and women who work in our Public Works Department for continuing to chug along as we see changes within that division. And so I just wanted to acknowledge that. Next, I'd like to recognize the change within our Parks and Recreation Division. First, I'd like to begin by stating my gratitude for the service and the commitment of Mr. Ison Harris. Ison issued his letter of resignation last week. And so I just want to thank him and the commitment that he has provided. Ison was here at the city even before I came. I think he was in an interim capacity when I met him. He did amazing things such as institute a splash pad in the Presidential Hills community. He was very instrumental in the efforts to get our golf course and Pete Brown up and moving. And so I thank him for his effort. I thank him for his time and dedication to the city of Jackson. And we're praying and wishing him well going forward. On the same note, I believe many of you are aware that the interim director of Parks and Recreation is Mr. Steve Hutton. Let me begin by saying that I am familiar with Steve in multiple capacities. One, as one of the commissioners on the Fairground Commission, I had an opportunity to be updated on his efforts and his work in his time as the director of the fairgrounds, and so I'm very familiar with his work product. In addition to being familiar with his work product as he served as the CEO of the fairgrounds, he also joined the city of Jackson as an employee to work on the improvements at the Pete Brown Golf Course. Prior to his time with us and prior to his time at the state fairgrounds, I believe that he oversaw the Sanderson Farm golf tournament, PGA golf tournament, when it was held at Annandale, I believe. And so he has a track record of success and accomplishment. Let me say this, because I know that there has been significant discussion about his conviction. I will share that, one, Mr. Hutton and I have had significant discussions about that conviction. And I am, I acknowledge that he has taken full accountability for his actions and, you know, that which he was convicted of. He has talked about what his vision and why it is important that he provide more to the community and work. And so I'm grateful for his conversation. I believe that it is important that when someone pays their debt, that we give them opportunity. The city of Jackson, some time ago, decided that we would ban the box. And what ban the box meant is that on applications, we would not ask if people had prior criminal convictions unless it was relevant to the job that they served in. And if we believe that we can ban the box for people who work in the lower levels of our employment, then certainly it would be hypocritical of us to say that we cannot allow people to work in the areas of their expertise if it were in directorships or so on and so forth. And so I am completely comfortable with the debt that he paid. I am completely comfortable with his acknowledgement of his failures in the past. And more importantly, I am completely comfortable with his skill and ability. I know that his mugshot has been shared widely across several platforms. And you know, while that is a part of the discussion, and I believe Mr. Hutton looks forward to addressing those matters at an appropriate moment in time, I think it is important that we ask the question, can he do the job? While many people shared his mugshot, no one or very few people actually asked the question, was he capable of achieving the job? Having worked for the city before, having been instrumental in the improvements at the Pete Brown Golf Course, having been instrumental in several improvements at the state fairgrounds, I thought it was imperative that we brought someone in who could provide the level of service, the level of quality that our residents deserve in our Parks and Recreation Division. That being the case, I want to be clear that the search, nationwide search, is still underway. We will be reviewing what is the best options moving forward for our Parks and Recreation Division. In my opinion, failure is not an option. In my opinion, we can no longer have residents that complain about the conditions of our parks. We can no longer have residents that are not fully taking advantage or benefiting from the quality of life they so justly deserve. And so my mission will always be to operate in the best interests of our city and bring forth people who are talented and skilled enough in order to make sure that we get past the challenges that we see today.